morning, good morning, good morning, St. Luke. Let's give the Lord a hand and a hope of praise. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Oh, how good it is that brethren can dwell together. Amen. Such a wonderful day. A fresh start. Amen. A new beginning. And we're giving God all the praise. To Jesus Christ, our Lord, to His Holy Spirit, to all our officers, members, and friends of St. Luke, I say it is a great day to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Praise the Lord. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we come this morning first to say thank you. Thank you for last night's sleep. And God, as we all slumber and set during the night and visit the world of dreams, God, you sent angels to watch over us and keep us safe during the night. And on time this morning, Lord, you woke us up, closing our right mind with the full uses of our body. And God, we say thank you. We pray now, God, that, Lord, that you look in our hearts, search us, Lord. For God, we realize, Lord, somewhere along the way, we made mistakes, we had shortages. But God, by your grace and your mercy, we ask for forgiveness, creating us a clean heart and then the right spirit. Because God, we desire to be pleasing in thy sight. Bless the service today. Bless the word that's going to come forth. Give us ears and hearts to hear what the Spirit now says to the church. Have your way, Lord. Heal someone. Deliver someone. Miraculize somebody's situation. So at the end of the service, oh God, we all be made better than when we came. We thank you in advance for what you will do and how we will be blessed. For it's in Jesus' name, our Lord and our Savior, we pray. Let the church say amen. 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 We honor the Lord today. We thank God for his goodness and his mercy on today. Praise the Lord. Amen. At this time, we will have a selection from our choir today. Praise God. And after that, we'll have our scripture and our prayer. Praise the Lord. All right? God bless you. And then
how great is our God, send me how great, how God, only see how great, how great. It's our God. Our great is our God. Sing me how great is our God. Only see how great is our God. He's a name above all names. He's worthy of my praise, and my heart will sing, how great is our God. He's a name above all names, and he's worthy of our praise, and my heart will sing,
next time Deacon Bill Lee will come with our scripture reading of the day, prayer will follow by Deacon Noah Clark. In the open. God bless you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Our morning scripture becomes in St. Mark, 5th chapter, verses 25 through 35. St. Mark, 5th chapter, beginning at the 25th verse. And I'm reading. In a certain moment, which had an issue of blood 12 years, and has suffered many things of many physicians, and has spent all that she had, and was nothing better, but rather grew worse. And she had heard of Jesus, came in and pressed behind and touched his garment. And she said, "If I may touch but the hem of his garment, I shall be whole." And straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she had heard, that she was healed of her plague. And Jesus immediately knowing in himself that the virtue had gone out of him, turned him about in the press and said, "Who touched my clothes?" And his disciples said unto him, "Thou seest the multitude throughout thee, saying, Thou who touched me? And he looked around about to see her that had done this thing. But the woman feared and trembled, knowing what was done in her, came and fell down before his feet, and told him all the truth. And he said unto her, "Daughter, thy faith hath made thee whole. Go in peace, and be whole of thy faith." While he yet spake, there came from the ruler of the synagogue house servant, which said, "Thy daughter is great dead. Why trouble thy the master any further?" I have just read the St. Mark, 5th chapter, verses 25 through 35. May the Lord have blessed you and read word. May his strength be down in our soul, and we live by it each and every day. Amen.
Father, Lord, we thank you. God, we thank you just for who you are, God. Lord, we thank you that you allowed us another time that we can come together and worship your name. Lord, we thank you for your many blessings, God. Blessings that we do not deserve, God. For, Lord, we deserve death, hell, and the grave, Lord. But you love us so much, God, that you allow us to see new mercies every day. And for that, God, we say thank you. Lord, we ask that you come and have your way in this service, God. Bless the man of God that's coming forth to break the bread of life, that he will say something to cause somebody to say, "What must I do to be saved?" Lord, let somebody be saved in this service, God. Let somebody be healed. Let somebody be delivered and set free, God. Lord, because today, Lord, all of us need something different, God. So, God, we ask that you just come, God, and bless us each one by one, God, and then bless us all together, Lord. Lord, because somebody in here today is coming on one leg, depending only on you, God. And so, God, we need you in this place, God. Lord, we need your power to come and fall upon us, God. Let your Holy Spirit reign among us, God. Lord, we're asking you to be among us, God. Be in this service. Be in us as we lead, God, so that we can live lives according to the way in which you would have us. us today. Lord, somebody wanted to be here today, God, but they couldn't, God. Somebody's in the hospital sick, God. Somebody's at home bedridden, God. Bless them right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, you know the desires of their heart, Lord. Bless them, God. Heal them, God. For you say in your word that by your stripes we are healed, God. And Lord, somebody today again is unsaved, God. Saved. Lord, somebody needs special deliverance, God. Deliver them on today, God. And we're going to give you the praise. We praise you for what you've already done. We praise you for what you're getting ready to do in this place, God. And as we go home and as we go through on this week, God, this work week, God, bless us all. Keep us all safe and pure from the danger. And we're going to continue to praise the glory of God because you are just that good. Lord, we can't thank you enough for who you are, God. You just continue to bless us over and over again. And if we had 10,000 tongues, Lord, we could not say thank you. So, God, we just going to say thank you with our mouths, thank you with our hands, thank you with our whole being, God, because you are worthy of all the praise. This is our prayer. In Jesus' precious name, amen.
So long I'm going through, Lord, was you. So all I'll go through, Lord, was you. It was you, Lord, it was you, pulling me through. So all, through all, I'll go through, Lord, it was you. Lord, it was you pulling me through. When I stumble, when I cry, when I feel like I wanted to die, when my friends turn and they walk away, you was right there to stay. It was you, Lord, it was you, pulling me through. It was you, Lord, it was you, pulling me through. When I stumble, when I cry, when I feel like I wanted to die, when my friends turned and they walked away, you was right there to stay. It was you, Lord, it was you, pulling me through. It was you, Lord, it was you, pulling me through.
We say amen. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand of praise and thanksgiving today. Praise the Lord. It's certainly good to be here. It's good to see all of you. We're thankful for our scripture reading by Deacon Bill Lee and for the prayer from Deacon Noah Clark and the chant from the choir and you and you. Praise the Lord. And we're thankful unto God today. Just want to say, isn't it good to wake up in the morning and have your right mind and then to have full strength? Come on, somebody. Come on, praise and pray. Full strength. And Lord, you're able to do for yourself. Praise the Lord. You know, I don't question, amen, when health care workers doing their job and on their assignment, helping others. But what a blessing it is when you can do for yourself. Can the church say amen? Don't take it lightly. Amen. It all comes from God. Praise the Lord. We thank you. This morning, I just got these few announcements to make. On tomorrow evening at 7 p.m., there will be a call meeting for all officers and members of St. Luke Church. I want you to know the trustees have informed me that they have a buyer for the property, so that we need to hear from them so they can do what's necessary. Amen. We've got a request from someone that wanted to buy the property that the church have had for sale. I think they made a very generous offer. So tomorrow night at 7 p.m., that's on the call line, the same line for Bible study. We ask all to join in at 7 p.m. tomorrow evening. Also, to all members, don't forget to pay your Sunday school dues. Pastors, $5. Ministers, $3. Members, $2. And that is the request from the superintendent of our Sunday school, Elder Frank Johnson. Praise God. So we do ask you to heed that. Continue to pray for our sick and shut in, and pray for our president and our vice president, our governor and our mayor. And I like to say, pray for one another, as you always do. We're living in some treacherous times. We understand now that the variant is rising. Matter of fact, in all 50 states. And I want to appeal to parents and to young people. Take the shot. It's the best defense we have right now. Amen. Even myself, me and First Lady have taken both shots, but we still wear our masks. Amen. I'm too responsible to do many. I'm not going to take that chance because I don't know who haven't been vaccinated. And according to science, let me just say this. The Bible says, give honor unto whom honor is due. We're in the midst of a pandemic, and these scientists and doctors have been authorized, and they have taken an oath through medical science to deem necessary to protect us in the midst of diseases and pandemic. So we need to respect what they're asking us to do. And I know nobody likes needles. I don't either. But it's the best way to administer the vaccine. And the time I've taken it, I mean, I didn't even feel a thing. I mean, it was in and out. Praise the Lord. I told the young man, a young lady did us the second time. A young man did us the first time. And, of course, I was studying because I used to be a phlebotomist as well as an instructor. So I was looking at his technique. He was smooth. Smooth. I mean, painless. I don't like pain with a needle, do you? Praise the Lord. So I just encourage you, please, ma'am and sir, get your children vaccinated. There's a lot of myths about the vaccine, but as for protocol, it is the best defense we have. I know we all got Jesus. We got him. I have to, but I'm still in the flesh. Come on, somebody. Amen. And so we just encourage you, man and sir, please get your children vaccinated. Hospitals are beginning to fill up again because of the virus. It's still real. It's still real. Don't let no one misguide you and think, well, hey, I ain't going to get it. Well, it's still here. You can get it. Praise the Lord. Amen. So let's do what's safe. Tomorrow evening at 7 o'clock, don't forget the call meeting on the conference line at 7 o'clock. Praise the Lord. And don't forget your Sunday school assessments. Amen. At this time, we will ask our stewards to come and prepare. Let us prepare in paying our tithes and our offerings and our assessments. The Lord is worthy of all our praise. And even through this moment in time, we're still worshiping God. And we're thanking him. Amen. By our due diligence, as we worship, we pay our tithes and our offering. What does the Lord require of thee? Love, mercy, walk justly before thy God and love thy neighbor as thyself. Will a man rob God? And what a question Malachi the prophet had asked. He said, yes, you can in your tithes and your offering. Let us not be held accountable. We know what our obedience is. As the source comes, let's prepare in giving. For the Bible declare, he that giveth unto the Lord, loan it to the needy. Praise the Lord. And one thing about it, you can't keep God giving no matter how you try. This source comes.
In the name of Jesus, we pray.
eternal God and Father. Thank you for every tithe, every offering. Some gave out of the last, but God, they gave out in obedience. And we pray, God, that you will bless, oh God, every hand, and Lord, every knee. We pray, Lord, you will provide. And God, I pray in the name of Jesus, you will anoint the tithe, the offering, to be used in this house, to bless your house, bless your people, God. And Lord, let every need be met. And we pray right now, in the name of Jesus, oh God, upon the membership of St. Luke Church, continue to heal, continue to bless, continue, Lord, to let us walk in abundance. For God, we know you're able to provide our every need. We pray today, God, for healing, for those that are sick among us, those that are struggling and going through some personal situation. But God, you take control. Help us to get through it. Help us, God, to find our healing, find our deliverance, and find our miracle. Lord, we thank you because, Lord, you said in your word that whatever we ask in your name, and have no doubt, it will be done. Thank you now, Father, for every blessing and for every miracle. And Lord, if we fail in asking, don't fail us in giving. But let the words of our mouths, meditation of our heart, be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and redeemer. In Jesus' name, let the church say amen. God bless you. God bless you. May be seated. May the Lord bless you. Amen. We know, amen, the best is having been dedicated, but we dedicate them now to the glory and the work of the Lord. Amen. I'm thankful. How about you? How many of you are glad to be here today? Lift them hands. Tell God, thank you.
Thank you, God.
I even hear the horn. Go to the horn. Praise the Lord. If you're on the bypass, blow your horn. Praise the Lord. Thank the Lord. He lets you live another day. Praise the Lord. At this time, we will have a selection from our choir today. And after that, I'll be coming from St. Mark, the fifth chapter. Praise God. I just want you to look at, amen, two verses. Amen, 33 and 34. Amen, St. Mark 5, 33 and 34. And after the choir sing this act spiritual, the pastor's coming back with the word. God bless you. Sing, Father. Praise the Lord.
Just not you.
the woman fearing and trembling, knowing what was done in her body, came and fell down before Jesus and told him all the truth. And Jesus said unto her, "Daughter, thy faith has made thee whole. Go in peace and be whole of all thy plague." I want to preach for a little while from the subject. It will change if you touch God. It will change if you touch God. Amen. That is my subject for today. It will change if you will touch God. Many times we have heard it or have said it ourselves. We need a touch from God. However, how important it is when we let go of our faith and reach out and touch God for ourselves, that God will move. The witness in our text today also proves in the pursuit of hope, we all have more in common in unity than we do apart from one another. For all of us need something from the Lord, and somebody need it right now. I believe I got a witness. We all have issues, don't we? We all got something we can't muster by ourselves. We need the Lord's help. I know there are times in life that we deal with unexpected circumstances and things come, amen, that we weren't looking forward to happening, but they do. And I realize that even in my situations, I've had to make a call to God and ask heaven for some help. Amen. See, we all have issues we cannot get past by ourselves without the Lord's help. Mm-hmm. 3 points in my message today, and I'll be out of the way. 1 point is, we all have issues. Amen. 2, we all have a desire to be made whole. And 3, to really get what God had for you, sometimes you got to press for it. Amen, amen. Jesus, in the text, the Bible tells us that again, he was faced with many in a crowd. Matter of fact, the word press means there was a mass crowd assembled around Jesus. And access to him was not that easy. Amen. I'm here to tell you this morning that your issues may be one thing and mine might be another, but we all need something from God. For many of us have issues with our health, issues with our finances, issues with our careers, or even on our jobs. Some have issues with their children, and others have issues with their marriage. And many of us have issues living a lifestyle that sometimes is questionable by what God told us to do. Have I got a praying church? It was an issue that literally ruined the life of this young lady for 12 years. And I want to say to you, I don't know what kind of sickness or pain you have in your body, but if you've had it for 12 years, that's a miserable experience. Am I right, somebody? Amen. But we learn from this text that she didn't never lose sight, that she desired to be made whole and wanted to live a normal life. It's important to realize that these issues that we find in the text can cause much difficulty and discomfort. This woman in the text, her life was slowly ebbing away because her life is in the blood. There are three things that her issue did to her. It made her weak. It made her unclean. It made her miserable. Amen. And that's a bad way to live. But the good news is she desired something from God. I stopped by to ask you a question. What is it that you desire from God? And I want to let you know there's nothing too hard for God. Sometimes in the issues of life, Satan got a way of trying to tell us in our mind that God has forgot about you. Or maybe God don't desire you to be made whole. But I stopped by to encourage somebody. My Bible tell me in John 10 and 10, Jesus said, I've come that you can have life and have it more abundantly. I believe that God wants us healed. I believe that God wants us to be free. I believe that God wants us to enjoy life. Have I got somebody to preach? Amen. Her desire secondly was to be made whole. Mark 5 and 26 says, she has suffered many things of many physicians and has spent all that she had. She was serious about her health. I don't know why folk won't wear that mask when they know they need to. I don't even know why people, we're in the midst of a pandemic, they don't even want to take the shot knowing that's the antibiotic against the virus. Come on now, some things the Lord ain't coming out of heaven to straighten out. He gave you the power and authority to do it. Come on, somebody. Sometimes we allow the devil to steal our blessings because we refuse to do what ought to be right. Okay. She tried to find a worldly deliverance for her misery, but she went to the wrong source. Many people today are trying to find happiness and joy in this life, and they're looking for it in the wrong places. Let me help you out with that. Some people think it's Johnny Walker. Some people think it's Budweiser. Some people call it Miller. Praise God. Amen. But I'm here to tell you, the name is Jesus. And whatever you need, Lord knows he's got it. Can I get a witness? She visited Dr. False Peace. But Dr. False Peace couldn't give up no peace. She still had her issues. She even tried Dr. Feelgood. But Dr. Feelgood didn't make her no better. She still had her pain. Amen. I'm here to tell you, beloved, that when God is in the midst of your situation, amen, he can turn it around and you'll be amazed how quick he can do it. And a lot of times, I just say this to help somebody. Amen. Budweiser, Jack Black, and Johnny Walker, amen, and the rest of them fellas. Amen. Can only get you high. But when you wake up, you got the same problem. Can I get a witness? But if you turn it over to Jesus, I'm here to tell you, he'll give you a cure, and it will never go away. Can the church say amen? The Bible says she tried all the earthly doctors, and none of them could do her no good. But not only did she see her desire, amen, slipping away. Amen. The third thing she had to do, she realized, I'm not giving up so easy. Sometimes the enemy will come, amen, to distort us from looking unto God. Let me make myself plain to what I'm saying. Amen. A lot of time, God don't answer us with the first prayer. Anybody know why I'm waiting on the Lord? Having the Lord taught you something about you got to wait on his time. And then you look back after he do the miracle and you say, Lord, thank you for working it out. Because, Lord, if it happened like I wanted it to, I would have missed this. And, Lord, I wouldn't have been that close to you. Sometimes the Lord allowed the enemy that space not to hurt us, not to hinder us, but just draw us closer to him. Because that's your prayer, just like mine. Lord, I want a closer walk with thee. Anybody in the room wants a closer walk with the Lord? You should, because the closer you get to him, the more you will appreciate his glory. Tell the Lord thank you. Amen. I'm here to tell you, look what it says here, that this woman with the issue of blood, she had been bleeding for 12 years, exhausted her funds, going to various doctors. No one knew what caused her cycle to be continuous. Now, those of you that are females know exactly what it is when the cycle comes on. It's unpleasant. There's cramps. It's messy. It's uncomfortable. It's irritable. It's a painful period. You really sometimes want to be by yourself. I believe I got somebody that know what I'm talking about. She had, amen, poked and prodded, amen, by many physicians. But at the end of the day, she still didn't have no cure. Amen. Look at what it says. The Bible says somebody near her knew something about Jesus. Aren't you glad you know something for yourself about Jesus? Come on, can I be real? Can you answer the call? And based on what you already know about Jesus, won't he be there for you? Won't he see you through it? There are tough times, requires tough faith. And this lady had faith. Hallelujah. To realize I ain't got nothing left. So I'm going to hold on. Look like that the only answer I can find that is real. I'm going to trust Jesus. Look at what it says. She made her way into town. Despite the fact that she wanted, amen, she wasn't wanted to be near no one. Sometimes we have to go where others may not want us. Amen. To be in the place God wants us so God can give us his best blessing. Do you know, I've had some trials. I go through some storms like you. But I've learned my faith gets stronger the more I talk to God and not focus on the problem. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Sometimes the enemy will deceive us with us focusing more on the problem than the one that's able to solve the problem. And that is God. Then the Lord said, cast all your care upon me, for I care for you. I've stopped by to prophesy to somebody. Stop carrying your problem and take your problem to the Lord. Stop focusing on your problem and turn it over to the Lord. He's able to turn things around. Tell the Lord thank you. Here she is pressing through the crowd. Clothes stained, body weary, ache and pain, a wretched inner body, pushing to get past one and then the other. But she's determined to let her faith go and just reach out and get a touch. Sometimes because of convenience, people will allow the enemy to hinder them. But this woman is determined. I don't care who ought to be next. I don't care who's head of the line. I believe it's mine. they will put you next in line. Maybe that's why the enemy is stealing your joy, telling you to have hate and malice in your heart, and you ought to be giving God glory, praise, and thanksgiving, and declaring by faith, I'm going to get my healing. I'm going to get my breakthrough. I'm going to get my blessing. In spite of what I'm dealing with right now, it's not over. But God said, if I'm for you, I'm more.
The spirit every now and then will give you a leap down in your soul where you just can't sit there and take it no more. Be your issue, illness, or attitude, be it addiction or affliction, be it, amen, habit or hardship, we can give it all over to Jesus. Like this woman pressed toward the prize, be like the woman, have enough faith in God and not your issues. To tell the Lord, I'm weak, but Thou art strong. I've got temperament, but You are peace in the midst of the storm. Have I got somebody to preach to? Oh yeah, your situation might be chaos, but Jesus is that lily in the valley. He's peace in the midst of your storm. Tell the Lord thank you. Yes, yes, yes. We may be at a low point, but sometimes we have to get real low before we have a sense enough to look up. I don't know what your issue is, but if you are at a low point, take lessons from this woman. I'm not going to quit. I'm not going to throw in the towel. I'm not going to accept status quo. Sometimes, church, we're bothered by folk talking about us. But let me help you. If they talk about Jesus, come on, where are my saints at? If they talk about Paul, if they talk about Moses, if they talk about Joe Dixon, they're going to talk about you. But you ought to have your mind made up in the midst of my issues. The things I can't change, I'm going to put it in the Lord's hand and let Him work it out. Say, yeah, I'm getting ready to take my seat. But let me tell you, here's what you do. Hallelujah. You take it to God and let God work it out for you. My last point, the Bible says she activated her faith. Mark 5:28. She said, if I may but touch the hem of his garment, I shall be made whole. I feel like preaching just a few more minutes. The Bible says, I said the Bible says, B-I-B-L-E, says she realized that God is able to provide a ram in the bush at Mount Moriah. See, some of you are still memorizing your perks, memorizing your pain. You have to memorize the word of God and the history of our God. He's able in the midst of every crisis. Oh yeah, she realized God is able to make a freeway down the Red Sea for Moses. He's able to make the sun stand still and turn back 10 degrees for Joshua. Lord knows he's able. He's able to keep Jonah alive in the belly of a big fish for 3 days. Come on, church. He's able to make a lame man walk after 38 years. She made up her mind. I don't have nothing to lose, but everything to gain. Can I get a witness? She touched the hem of his garment. She activated her faith. Her faith moved God. And Jesus said, who touched me? Let me help somebody. When you let go and let God, something gonna move and something gonna change. God will heal your body. God will cover your sins. God will restore you again. Will he do it? Have I got a few witnesses that know he's able? When I'm weak, he'll make you strong. When you're sad, he'll make you glad. When you're by yourself, he'll be right there. Ain't he all right? Say yeah. I'm so glad she lets us know you can't make me doubt it. I know too much about it. Everything you do, did he wake you up this morning? Start you on your way. You're still breathing, still walking, still talking, still alive. Tell him thank you. Say yeah. Say hallelujah. Come on, give him some praise. He didn't have to do it, but he did. Say yes. Thank you. Of your faith. Focus on God, because God alone will provide your every need. Yes, he will. And what I love about God, he never gets too tired.
That's right.
You know, on my answering service, it's limited. After so many calls, the friendly operator will come up and say, the message line is full. Can I get a witness? But if you dial heaven and call on Jesus, he'll answer right now. Can I get a witness? Hallelujah. If you take it to God and let him have it,
already there.
It's a done deal. You won't leave the way that you came. Because it's already done. Today, I appeal. If there's somebody in the congregation or even in the automobile, even if you're on Highway 70 or in Main Street, LaGrange, and you heard this word today and you've got some issues, then you're not alone. Jesus is the master healer. He knows all about it and he can fix it if you let him. But if you want a cure that's real, I dare you to come to Jesus as you are. I'm going to ask the congregation to stand. The choir's going to sing. I'm going to extend an invitation. Somebody want to join the church. Come on. Somebody want to be saved today and give your life to Christ and be sure about your salvation. Will you come today? And then I'm going to appeal somebody, amen, that need a miracle or a breakthrough. Praise God. Come on, stand around the altar. Just stand around. Martin, take faith. Amen. In the midst of what you're dealing with, and say to the enemy, I believe God in spite of, I believe God. Like the woman in our text, she'd been through a lot in 12 years, but she made up her mind, I'm going to touch and I won't let go until my miracle comes. Is there one today? The choir sings, my brother, my sister, will you come? Praise God. Is there one? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Someone. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. He's able. Thank you, God. He's able. And just as I pray, come to me. It's not me, not my neighbor, not my mother, father, sister, not my brother. Just face around, just face around, just face around. It's me alone, standing
Shared with you what God has given for me to share with you today.
today, Satan. And the message is simple. Amen. Amen. Take it to God. Whatever it is, take it to God. You leave it there. Don't you pick it up and put it back in your pocket. Leave it at his altar. And I know he will do it. And we will turn things around and make everything all right. Praise the Lord. Yes, he will. But you got to leave it. Leave it in his hand. She's a perfect example of what faith in God alone will do if you trust him. Amen. She won't look at nobody else. She won't focus on what she already been through. She will focus on the one that can heal her. And that's what we need to keep our faith in the Lord. And he'll help us to make this journey. Won't he do it, somebody? Praise the Lord. We thank the Lord. Amen. At this time, are there any other announcements? Any announcements? Praise God. All right. Take a minute. All right. Mother Trumpet. God bless you.
You know, I have a word.
God bless you.
It's a beautiful message.
Bless you. Bless you. Thank you.
We all have issues. You said we all have issues.
Amen.
But if we actually lay our faith and press on, God will give us the signs of our heart.
Amen.
Thank you, God. For
Amen.
The message.
The presence of God in the Old Testament, the high priests, the Levites, and the priests, you had Levites, priests, but the high priest, he was the only one who was the intercessor for man. To go in the Holy of Holies, look, they had to slay animals, blood, then they put it in a barrel and mix it with spices. And it created a sweet aroma. And then God would go in a holy holy and offer it up. And when the smoke would go up to heaven,
God would smell it. And then he began pardon and favor upon the people. The man of God would do this once a year. Praise God. And that's how they kept the favor of God.
We are so blessed.
We don't have to wait once a year to go to God for anything. You can go right now because Jesus is our intercessor and then our high priest. Tell the Lord thank you. And he's the one right now interceding because, you know, the enemy is fighting us 24 hours a day. You know that. We're at war 24 hours a day. But Jesus makes it so easy because he's on the right hand of God interceding for us. And with his angels, amen, they are declaring victory over every one of us. So you enjoy the goodness of the Lord and keep your faith in him. And I say that today, God will get you through it. Just let him have it and leave it in his hand. Praise the Lord. May the Lord bless you all. May y'all have a marvelous day. We thank God for our choir and our musicians, to our ushers and all of you. May you have a pleasant day. Join us tomorrow evening at 7 p.m. on conference line. Praise God for a call me. All right? If all minds and hearts are clear, may we all sing. I got a question. Why do we all go to bed? Why do we all go to bed at night? Okay, that's fair. But why do we go to bed at night? That now, the answer is simple. The bed can't come to you. Shall we look to the Lord? May his grace, sweet communion of his Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide in every heart, henceforth, now, and forever, until we all meet again. In Jesus' name, let the church say, amen, amen, amen. Amen. And God bless you all. God bless you all.